Hello children, this is your physics teacher Sharma and I welcome you all back to my class again. In the previous class, we have started a new chapter, metals and non-metals, in which we have learned all the physical properties of metals. In that class, we have learned that metals are hard to touch, metals are lustrous, metals are malleable, metals are ductile, metals are sonorous, and metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. So these are the physical properties of metals. We have learned that metals are hard to touch, for which the exception is potassium and sodium, which are very soft. We have learned that all metals are lustrous. Okay, that means they will be having a shine. Okay, with this shine. Now coming to the third one, metals being malleable. We have learned that being malleable is the property by which we can beat the metal into a sheet, for which of course zinc is an example. And metals are ductile. Ductile means they can be drawn into long wires. We have learnt that gold and silver and platinum, these kind of noble metals, are highly ductile, so they can be drawn into very thin wires. And again, zinc is an exception to that. We have learnt that metals are sonorous. Sonorous means they can produce sound. They produce a metallic sound. Okay, we know why the bells are made up of iron or any other metal, because they produce a very loud sound. You don't get that much sound when you strike two non-metals, for say two pieces of coal. Coal is nothing but carbon and carbon is a non-metal. When you strike two pieces of coal against each other, you don't hear any sound. On the other hand, if you strike two pieces of metal one against the other, then you do hear a very loud sound. So these are the physical properties of metal. Now let us look into the chemical properties. Okay, we know very well that when we are speaking about chemical properties, we are actually talking about a new substance or a new compound being formed. Okay, and for a new compound to be formed, we need some new element with which they react with. As a part of that, today we will discuss what happens when these metals and non-metals react with oxygen. Okay. Now, whenever metals and non-metals, they react with oxygen, they form their oxide. And this is not something new out of the world and which we never notice. You might have seen many places where iron gates, okay, the iron grills of the house, they actually get rusted. How is this happening? Metals are reacting with the oxygen which is there in the air, in the presence of moisture as well, to form its oxide, which is nothing but rust. Okay, so this metallic oxide is formed. Iron oxide is nothing but rust. So when iron is combining with oxygen, it is forming iron oxide. There is one very nice experiment, very interesting experiment, which we can see happening. Okay, when we take a magnesium ribbon and we burn it, we see that this magnesium ribbon will be burning with a dazzling white light, which is very dazzling. The word dazzling is used to describe the light that is given by this magnesium. Okay, and along with that, it will also leave a white color powder. Now, what is that white color powder? Magnesium. It is burning in the presence of oxygen to form magnesium oxide, and that magnesium oxide is formed, like as I said, magnesium, it is combining with oxygen to form magnesium oxide. Okay, is it only these reactive metals like magnesium, iron, they combine with oxygen? No, not only that. Copper, which is not very reactive, that also combines with oxygen. Okay, when we see normally in our houses that copper vessels will be having a greenish layer formed at the top. Okay, so when copper vessels are exposed for a long time, there will be a dull green coating formed on their surface. Okay, that is because of, again, the same thing. This copper combines with water which is there in the atmosphere along with some carbon dioxide and oxygen to form copper hydroxide and copper carbonate. Okay, so they are reacting in the presence of oxygen or with oxygen directly. They are combining with them to form a new compound. However, oxides are formed when metals react with oxygen. Okay, now if I take this oxide which is formed, for example, I have taken a magnesium ribbon, I burn it, I got white color powder. That white color powder I dissolve in water and I will also heat it if necessary to make a solution. And that solution, if I test with a litmus paper, you know why we use a litmus. Litmus is used to know whether the given solution or substance is acidic or basic. So I am using this litmus paper to test this magnesium oxide dissolved in water. What color change do you think will be seen? We will see that red litmus changes into blue. And this red litmus changing into blue is usually exhibited by bases. Okay, so metal oxides, when dissolved in water, they give us base. This is one important preparation of bases which we can remember. Now, is it that only metals react with oxygen? No. Combining with oxygen is not confined only to metals. Even non-metals also combine with oxygen. For example, sulfur. An yellow color powder, sulfur, when it is burned or when it is heated, it will combine with the atmospheric oxygen to form sulfur dioxide, which is a poisonous gas. That sulfur dioxide, it will dissolve in water to form sulfurous acid, H2SO3. Okay, so this sulfurous acid, the name itself says it is an acid. If I try to test this with a litmus paper, then it shows acidic property. Now, let us go one step back. I took sulfur powder and I heated it. I see the fume coming, I can see some gas coming out. If I take a moist litmus paper, a litmus paper which is wet, moisture is nothing but water. So I have taken a moist litmus paper, okay, and I test for this fume, for whether it is acidic or basic. What change do I notice? It is obvious. Blue litmus changes into red. That means non-metallic oxides will form acids when they are dissolved in water. So, what are the things we have learned today? We have learned that metals like iron, magnesium will combine with oxygen to form metallic oxides. We have learned that metallic oxides, when dissolved in water, they behave like bases and so they change red litmus to blue. We have learned that non-metals also will react with oxygen to form non-metallic oxides. We have learned that these non-metallic oxides, when dissolved in water, they form acids, and these acids are converting, or it is changing, blue litmus to red. So this is how metals are reacting with metals and non-metals are reacting with oxygen. With the next topic, we'll meet again in the next class. Until then, have a nice time. Bye-bye.